Till now, we have seen all the functions which are non-recursive functions. Now, let us see how we can find the time complexity of recursive functions. Okay. Now, let me take one simple example of a recursive function, that is finding the factorial of a number. We have seen this example before. Now, let me take this example again. Okay. So, let us say we have to find, we have to write a function to find the factorial of a number, and this number is int n. Fine. Now, this is a non-recursive program. So, what I can do is I can take a variable I and j. So, I can take int I comma j is equal to 1, then for I is equal to 1, or you can say I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n, and I plus plus, we have to make j is equal to j multiplied by I. Fine. This is a very simple program to find the factorial of a number. As you can see, it is a very simple program. Okay. Now let me write a recursive functions here. Function here also. Let me take fun int n. If n is equal to 1, then return 1. Or you can say if n is equal to less than equal to 0, that is also a valid case. Both these cases are valid. Fine. Then else we can do fun, else we can do n into fun of n minus 1. Okay, so this is a recursive function. How we found this recursive function? We already know what is the mathematical form, mathematical way of finding the factorial of a number. What is the factorial of a number? We have to do, if we want to find the factorial of n, then this can be written as 1 if n is equal to 1, right? Or it can be written as n into factorial of n minus 1 otherwise. So this is the factorial of a number in mathematical way. So I am giving the same thing into this function. Okay, now let me see in this case how many times this for loop will run. This for loop will run approximately order of n time. You have seen this example a lot of times. I have told you this example a lot of times. And it's a very simple example to find the time complexity. But here in this case, there are no for loops. There are no while loops. And still, we are finding the factorial of a number. Right? But what we have done here is, we have used recursive programming. Right? We are calling this function recursively. And every time we are passing the value of n minus 1. Okay. Now, if you want to find the time complexity of this function, you have to identify how many times this whole function will be executed. Right? Remember what I am saying. Here in this case, these statements are being repeated. These statements are repeated because of this for loop. But here in this case, the whole function is repeated because every time I am calling this function again. How it is repeating? We can say, if you want to find the factorial of a number n, or you want to find the factorial of a number n, then to find the factorial of a number n, right, what you are doing n into factorial of n minus 1, which we already know, factorial of n minus 1, which we already know, and we know that if the value of n is less than equal to 0, then it is 1. Then what you can do is, time taken to find factorial of n numbers, let us suppose the value which we passed is n, then we can say in what time we can identify the factorial of a number. Then we can say time taken to find the factorial of a number n is equal to time taken to find the factorial of a number which is n minus 1, time taken to find the factorial of a number which is n minus 1, plus time taken to perform, to do this constant operation, that is time taken to compare this value and time taken for this multiplication. Now every time whenever you are going to compare this value, this is going to take constant time, which is equal to order of 1, and this also going to take constant time. You can write this as order of 1 or plus c as a constant value. Fine. Or you can make this, write this function as time taken to find a factorial of a number is equal to time taken to find the factorial of a number which is n minus 1 plus constant time to perform this multiplication and to perform this multiplication, right? So you can see here, this is a recursive call. Time taken to find n is equal to time taken to find n minus 1 plus constant, right? For simplicity, I am going to take this one, okay? Now let us try to solve this. In this case, you can see, next time, if you want to find the value of t of n minus 1, we have to substitute this value here, then t of n minus 1 will be, put n minus 1 in all these cases. Instead of n, whenever you are going to get n, put n minus 1 in that case. Then this will become t of n minus 1 minus 1 plus order of 1, which is equal to t of n minus 2 plus order of 1. Right, that means time taken to find the factor of n minus 1 is equal to t of time taken to find the factor of n minus 2 plus order of 1. Put this value here in this case. Then this will become time taken to find the factor of n is equal to time taken to find the factor of n minus 2 plus order of 1 plus order of 1. Fine. Now you have to identify what is the value of this. Now let me find the value of t of n minus 2. What is time taken to find the factor of n minus 2? It will be equal to put n minus 2 in case of n. Every time where you wherever you are going to get n, put the value of n as n minus 2. Therefore, it will become time taken to find the factor of n minus 2 minus 1 plus order of 1. Right. So here in this case, I have substituted the value which is n minus 2, which is equal to time taken to find the factor of n minus 3 plus order of 1. Again, put this value in this equation. So it will become time taken to find the factor of n is equal to time taken to find the factor of n minus 3 plus order of 1 plus order of 1 plus order of 1. Fine. Now if you extend this, then you can identify that it is time taken to find the factor of n is equal to time taken to find factor of n minus k plus order of plus k into order of 1 plus k into order of 1. Here it is 3 into 1. Here it is here if you case in this case you can see it is 2 into 1, and here in this case you can see 1 into 1, right? Therefore it is k into 1. Fine. Now when this function will be terminated, this recursive call will be terminated when the value of n is less than or equal to 0, right? Or you can say, if I just write the statement as if n is equal to 1, then return 1. I can also write this as 1. Fine. In that case, you can say, if the value of number is 1 or less than 1, then it is going to take order of 1 time, that is a constant time. Now, when I want to find the value of t of n minus k, then we can say, let k is equal to n minus 1. Right. Now, if we take k is equal to n minus 1, then this statement will become t of n is equal to t of n minus 1 plus n minus 1 into 1. So, why I have taken k is equal to n minus 1? Because I want to eliminate this statement. And to eliminate this statement, I have to make this statement as 1. If I can make it t of 1, then I know what is the value of t of 1. Fine. In that case, what this will do? This is t of n minus n plus 1 plus n minus 1. Here n to n cancel, therefore it can be written as t of 1 plus n minus 1, and t of 1 is order of 1. So it can be written as t of 1 plus n minus 1, which is equal to order of n. Hence, this complete function is going to be executed order of n times. That means if we write a recursive program to find a factorial of a number or a non-recursive program to find a factorial of a number, then both of them are going to take order of n time. Fine. It was a very simple example. I hope you understand what I am doing here is. Let me repeat it again. What I am doing here is, for a recursive program, for a non-recursive program, we can easily identify how many times the for loop is executing or how many times any loop is being executed. And according to that loop, we can find the time complexity, right? But in case of recursive program, we don't know how many times the statements will be executed. The statements will be executed on the basis of number of recursive calls. And then we have to identify what are the number of recursive calls. And according to those recursive calls, we can find the time complexity.